second?
I'll second.
Awesome. There's a first and a second, any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, nay. Being the chair, ayes have it, motion carries. We'll move now into public comments. 15-minute time period for citizens to appear and express their views before the Decatur vote by their board. Another 3 minutes per speaker, total of 15 minutes. No immediate response will be given by the library trustee or library staff members.
Who are you?
No, I'm sorry.
Hi, I'm Rebecca.
Yes, so this is my friend Rebecca.
Hi, Rebecca.
Hello.
It's interesting to see what the library board, how I operate at my board. I had library board meeting sentiments, so she's here with you. Seeing though that there is no public comment, is there any written communication for the public?
Yes. Normally I would say I'd be happy to share it with you. This time I'll say I will share it with you, but I won't be happy to. I'll be embarrassed to share it with you. Because I kind of, usually I'm very measured in my responses and even-handed, and I was not. My tone was certainly one of frustration. And someone emailed and was upset about, there was a program here, not a library program, someone secured the room as they had the right, as every group in this community has a right to do. And had a program. Another small group apparently was upset about that program. Actually disrupted the program. We know all the people here. We know everyone involved. Everyone I'm talking about, we know. We know in this room. The person who emailed me wanted the library to take responsibility for the person exercising their First and 14th Amendment rights by having a program at the public library. And I explained to this person in no uncertain terms that we cannot stop someone from engaging in protected speech. That protected speech in this case was a cheesy horror movie around Halloween, which is what I said. You're upset over a cheesy horror movie. They were also upset that a group that has a bad reputation, if you click on our mentions, this group mentioned the library, not understanding clearly that we can't control who mentions us on Facebook. And I was very frustrated and did not try to hide that frustration in the email exchange. And I will share it at your request, I will tell you in advance I'm embarrassed by my tone. I'm not embarrassed by what I said, but I am embarrassed by my tone. So, that is the written communication for the public. They said they wouldn't come to you because you guys were all handpicked by me and to do my bidding, and wouldn't go to the Secretary of State because he's also one of
okay, so the written communication is what? What was written?
Kind of that she was upset that we would host that program, which we I guess technically did per our policy. Any community group that wants to use the room can use the room. Another person again disrupted said program, and staff handled that. This would have been on Monday, we've been the 17th, because when I left, it happened while I was in the air on my way to Rosemont at the Library Association conference. So, as soon as I took my phone off of airplane mode, and the person that was hosting the program was entirely appropriate and did nothing wrong, pretty much as I believe the staff handled it appropriately, and the person who disrupted eventually left. And I consider that a warning. If they disrupt further programs, I will be looking at a ban from the library.
But they should be accused of having pornography for children also, that part of that group, that, so.
Understood, I appreciate that, okay, thank you for bringing it to the board's attention. That's all written communications, I assume?
Yep.
Okay, good. We'll move forward to new business, personnel update, discussion item.
Today I chose a candidate from the, for the part-time library assistant position. Not gonna say who it was because this person had not been contacted yet to get the offer. But I sent, I made my selection for civil service and sent it off to the city, and they will, for civil servant, they're the ones who do the formal offer. And so we should have, hopefully, we should have somebody in that position by the beginning of the next pay period. The next pay period actually starts Monday, so it'll be 2 weeks from Monday. That's pretty much it.
Awesome, appreciate it. All right, well, any other discussion?
Just an FYI, I'll be bringing the full proposal to the finance committee next week, but we do have a proposal from Library Strategies to help us through our strategic planning next year. So we'll be talking more about that later at the full board meeting.
All right, seeing no other discussion, I'm going to move forward to old business. First is diversity, equity, and inclusion discussion.
I believe Carl and Shelley got sent I sent emails, and we'll be having a meeting, I think it's next Wednesday at noon, the committee to sort of begin to follow up on Deanna Jones's recommendations. Also, we have secured Nikki Bond to do help us with our staff in service.
Next week?
November 16th. And so she will be doing a 2-hour sort of introduction to DEI concepts in the afternoon. You guys are all welcome to attend. It's in Madden.
The meeting next Wednesday, though.
Oh, I don't think I said it twice, but did we reserve this? Do you remember?
It doesn't ring a bell to me.
But
it's possible.
We've been doing it electronically, so I didn't think to reserve a room. But I will see if this room is available.
Did Katie ask me to reserve it? Is it possible?
She may have.
I think Katie asked me to reserve it.
Okay, so this room? Okay. I'll double check that.
I'll come to the library regardless, which is the I'll look for it. They can email something.
I don't intend to continue on the committee, but I want to sort of make clear to the committee what I want to make sure that we have a clear charge and clear expectations and timelines and stuff like that.
Sounds good. Any discussion? Seeing no, before the remote work policy action, I do believe that we're.
We're still in the We were talking about that when you walked in. I'm happy. I see a few options here. Either we just let it stop. I mean, it's been a standing item for 8-9 months, and nobody seems the worse for it not having been passed. The other thing is I could try one more time with Mr. Zinteria, maybe CC a couple of you guys on it. That might. I don't think he's intentionally stonewalling. I think it's just falling off his radar.
So he has to seem to approve the manager.
Well, there are insurance concerns, and he is our liability insurance is the city. Our liability insurer is the city of Decatur. Except for this is actually a workman's comp concern, and they do contract that out now. But they provide us, the city provides us with that workman's comp insurance. Last conversation I had with him, he had just received some guidelines from the insurer as to what kind of home work safety guidelines needed to be developed. He said he hadn't had a chance to take a look at them yet. He would do so in the next few days and get back to me. I sent him another reminder email after that. I don't want to have a workman's comp issue come up and then our insurer say, well, I want to make sure that we've got think there could be some benefit to, not only to the library, but to individual library employees for having this policy that we've come up with, but I don't think it's mission critical. So I think you've got to table it again.
And I'll
take whatever direction this committee wants to give me on that procedure.
I'm having a thought, and it's not fully formed, so I'm just...
Will somebody second it?
Second.
My fully formed thought, it seems to me if you're working from home, and it's a choice to work from home, you're taking the risk in your own home that would be covered under any insurance that you carry, not what your employer carries.
Except the state of Illinois disagrees with you. If you're on the clock, you are subject to workman's, you are subject to the benefits of workman's comp.
Okay, well...
That's kind of a moot point now, they've already said.
Yeah.
Okay, well, never mind.
You're approaching it from a common sense perspective.
Well, that makes sense to me.
And that never works.
Right, okay, well...
For further clarification, we know that he, Mr. Visitor, is looking like to get back to us, but and exactly what part of stage the process is in which is the final insurance clearance by the city to...
My understanding is he's fine with the policy as written, but we need an addition of workplace safety expectations, home workplace safety expectations. So what you can and can't do, you have to designate a home office within your home, and if you're outside of that, like if you're in your kitchen and you cut yourself with a knife while you're on the phone with a work phone call, that's not covered under workman's comp. So the insurance company had given him set guidelines, is my understanding, and he was reviewing them and was going to get back to me. Because they're in the same boat. They're wanting to do something similar to City of Decatur is. So, but he wants to make sure that our workman's comp insurance company is going to honor claims. You know, so he wants to make sure that we've got those guidelines set up.
I was thinking that was exactly what I was saying. There's something I need to come to City Hall and talk about. I'm just like, right, we're going to figure out what the city's at in their process and in that situation there, too, because obviously they're slowing us up just because.
It seems like they need it, too.
It's for their clarification.
And, you know, maybe I just pick up the phone tomorrow and try to get him on the phone.
If you have to get him on the phone, just call him and press the phone.
All right. I will call him tomorrow for sure.
Especially if it's just a review of the policies at the moment.
So we table this?
It's the first discussion right now, so seeing no further discussion, all in favor, say the proper saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, nay. Again, Chair, ayes have it. Motion carries. Motion is tabled, sorry, not carried.
Management personnel policy.
I have one final piece before I want to move forward on this. I just want direction for you guys. Do we want to pursue a parental leave policy?
Yes.
So, in other words, it would be something where a new parent, either adoptive or birth, father or mother, gets X amount of time off, paid or unpaid. And we have to look at, unpaid, FMLA already covers it. Paid, FMLA doesn't cover it for everybody. It doesn't cover the part-timers. I can tell you that there are some peer libraries that are going with paid time off. Okay, so I will look at, and does 4 weeks sound reasonable, or more, or less, or, and I'll have Chris write something up, is why I'm asking.
I was just talking to a colleague today who is 29
keep in mind that there's still vacation time and sick time, and they could combine it. I'm not saying, but how much additional, you know, paid time off do we want to add for new parents? I've seen anywhere from 2 to 6 weeks.
I think that 4 weeks.
4 seems reasonable to me.
That I would go with it with their parents.
If they're able to combine it with other time.
So.
Like if I have.
So you're saying 4 to 4 weeks off, but how much additional time off?
I'm saying.
Would they already get?
Maybe I'm confused about the question then. I have 4 weeks of PTO, let's pretend, and now you're giving me 4 weeks of parental leave, and so now I have 8 weeks off for.
Okay, so you're saying 4 weeks. And then with the understanding that they can combine it with other,
yes,
including, I would say, FMLA if it applies, and you could take further time, yeah, unpaid.
Yeah. 4 weeks for a new parent is nothing.
I agree with that. But right now, you know, and for the past 150 years, we've given $0 for it.
Uh-huh.
So
we're progressive.
Want to be progressive.
I agree, but I've said so. But we have to come up with a number.
I'm just saying
what we offer, and what the cap is that you can like do it one time. Like say she says she's taking 12 months, right?
Well, FMLA kind of dictates that. So
yeah.
So I would say, I mean, you can.
I would say 4 weeks paid.
And it can be combined with extra time also. Okay.
Yes.
All right. That's what I'll have. I'll have Chris write something up. We'll move forward.
Sorry, that was a discussion item.
It was an action item, but I want to table until Chris gets back.
That motion, yeah, that's what it is. I will accept the motion to table.
Second.
Awesome. Any discussion? Same room. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, nay. Okay, the chair has had a motion. This is tabled. We'll now move forward to the trustee bylaws action item. As I say, packets.
Yeah, so President Zathalas asked me to consider Amendment 2 under Article 10, Section 1. Yeah. And hear me out before I want to, there's a whole spiel I've got to give you on this, I'm sorry. But it says, Article 10, Section 1 says, attend all board meetings if a trustee misses more than 3 consecutive regularly scheduled committee meetings or 3 consecutive full board meetings, the board president or designee will contact the absent member and consult about their possible resignation. It used to say that, and I told Sophia, it used to say that person would be removed. That's not correct. What it used to say was the board president or designee will contact the absent member and ask for their resignation. Now, I looked at some other board bylaws and to get examples. The Illinois Library Association just says, if you miss more than 3 meetings in a year without excuse, your seat is considered vacated. But they're a 501c3 corporation. They're not a public entity. So I looked at IHLS, which is a public entity, the Illinois Harmon Libraries system, and they've got a fairly complex, but it does end with 3 meetings in a year, and the seat will be vacated unless 2/3 of the board says no. So I'm like, okay, but there's still IHLS, although they're a public entity, they are organized under a different statute than municipal public libraries. So I looked at statute, I didn't really see anything. I looked at some other public libraries. I looked at one other public library, the one who I look at their policies all the time as a model, Oak Park Public Library. There's nothing in there about removal. So I emailed Library Council, who said that the board can only remove another board
that, now, and our council did say, you could write a bylaw that says we will recommend to the mayor, you know, by 2/3 vote, or simply it will automatically be recommended to the mayor. So I kind of texted Sophia today and told her, and she would like some kind of amendment to this, and understands that it can't be done what she wanted. I'm almost finished, I promise. And I recommended that we wait until she's here next month to see exactly what she's thinking. I also want to say this, I'm just going to say this in a very general way. It is always best to only amend policies if you think it makes a better policy, not to address a particular individual instance or person or incident. It's that is, you know, I'm not a fan of amending policy to take care of a particular problem. So.
But yeah, so this is what ours says currently, because it says three consecutive.
Correct. That is what it says currently.
This is the proposal. This is not what actually.
No, this is what our current, this is our current policy.
It's our current policy, and our president would like us to readdress that policy.
She wanted to make it more cut and dry. And I thought it had been in the past, and I told her that it had been in the past. It was slightly more cut and dry in the past. Instead of saying, consult about possible resignation, it said, ask for resignation. But again, that's it. If the person says no, then that person says no. Illinois law says that for municipal libraries, under 75.5 ICLS, that's you guys, you can remove the board can remove one of their own if they had missed 12 meetings in a year.
Oh, no, we said they never came.
Essentially, right. Right.
So, essentially. Yeah,
right. It does say regular. It's bad. That's the other thing. So that person could go to, if I read it correctly, if you had one special meeting and the person went to that one special meeting, or if you had 12 special meetings, they came to all the special meetings, but missed 12 regular meetings, you could do it. But that'd be a really weird situation.
So because of
what I found out about 2 hours ago.
And that was prior to, that was after your last conversation with President.
Well, I texted her after that and said, given what, you know, I forwarded her Chris Adilla's email, and I said, given this information, she said she'd still like to adopt a bylaw, because Chris said you could adopt a bylaw that recommend that you will, after X number of absences, you will recommend that the president will recommend to the mayor removal. So said it wouldn't have, it would still be up to her, or him, the mayor. She said she would still like to adopt a bylaw, and I said I would recommend that if that's what you want, I want to know exactly what you're thinking. So that, I said, let's wait till December when you're here. So,
yeah, she'll be on the entire this month.
No, she'll be here for the full meeting. We can talk about the full board meeting. We're happy to do that.
Another motion table that we need.
Yes, I believe that we table this until the full board meeting. Second.
Second on the floor, any discussion? Seeing none. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, nay. Chair and Chair, I have a motion of carries. Sorry, motion is tabled.
I don't know if this is the place to bring this up or not. Maybe it's under discussion. It's about potential. I was asked to find out some information about a potential board, new board member. Should I talk about that now, or should I?
That's up to the chair.
Or should I wait till other?
We've got one more business
out. Okay, just one statement. I talked with Mayor about possibly with Mary Garrison. I know there was concern because she denied it last time. She said the reason for her denial was she understood it was a conflict of interest with her husband being on
allows for two city council members to sit on this board. So.
I mean, she didn't even want to make the call herself.
I understand. I understand.
That's what she understood, so she said, I'll apologize.
No, I know this guy doesn't like, certainly, I mean, has a different approach than Tim. Tim wanted a city person on every board.
Yeah.
You know, and Scott says, no, we're separate. Yeah, so.
I'm sure of it. I'm gonna go ahead and knock out this last action item, which is the staff social media policy.
Yeah, so I don't know how I've not put this in front of you guys in a few years, but I haven't. And I don't like any policy not being reviewed at least once every 3 years. And this has not been reviewed since it was adopted in 2016. I have no recommendations for changes on this. I think it's still a solid policy. I want to reiterate, this is a staff social media policy. It has nothing to do with the public. I'm hoping that next month I'm going to bring a policy about our own library managed social media sites, because there's some legal things that I learned in the ILA conference that I want to get into a policy. So, but this is just for staff use of social media. This has been vetted by council. And you can probably guess what language comes from him and what language comes from me. But I think it's a sound policy as written. I think that the only thing that I saw in here that we could get rid of is, I don't think we have to enumerate Facebook, Tumblr, Twitter, Instagram. That's obviously.
Snapchat, Twitch.
Obviously, Tumblr is gone. I believe completely.
I don't think it's gone completely, but it's definitely off everyone's radar.
MySpace is still around too. Flickr, I don't think is used. Anyway,
yeah.
It seems silly to enumerate them because everybody knows what social media is by now.
Are they currently?
They're on the second end of the second paragraph.
It says Facebook.
Including but not limited to Facebook, Tumblr, Flickr.
I started reading below that, honestly.
But I just find some of this ambiguous, like employees are discouraged from accessing online networking sites. It doesn't say they can't, it says they're
correct.
Discouraged.
Correct.
Discipline action may result.
Yeah. Well,
so they can get on social media when they're at work, is that?
Here's what, they actually use it.
I mean, they're going to, but.
And they also actually use it for work sometimes too.
I do too.
Yeah.
Question. Do you have a thing that the employees sign, like an agreement that says, I won't do these things?
We do, and I don't know that I've had it signed. We're supposed to sign it annually. I'm not sure that from the last couple of years.
We
have something that says there's no expectation of privacy. There's, when you're using library emails and no expectation of privacy.
I am confused again. Employees are discouraged from accessing online networking sites during work time unless authorized for library purposes.
Right.
Okay, so it's not for library purposes. They're discouraged, but they're not told they can't.
And I'm happy to strengthen that. What you hear is, well, this was for work.
Even on both sides, the numerous hats that I wear, oftentimes I'm just messaging people on Facebook about an event that's going on. So, I can see for other persons, there's a retasking event coming on, promoting it. So, nevertheless, then obviously when everyone's spending all their time on Twitter, when they're
I think you've got other.
If you see someone who's on Twitter all the time. There's no teeth in this that says you can say.
Right, but they're not going to get their job done. You know what I'm saying? They're, if they're doing that, they're not going to get their work done. And you're going to have other ways to address that. Which does bring up the question, why put it in there at all? And I admit that that's worth discussing.
Disciplinary action may result if you adversely affect the performance. Okay, it just means it's a discretion of the supervisor.
Yeah, it's hard to determine if that's what is adversely affecting your work performance, but if your work performance is poor, then other things that can be done too.
Just take that equation to do that here in my English. But I'll motion to present the staff social media use policy. Any discussion? Seeing none, all fair, supervisor saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, nay. Get it, chair ayes have it, motion carries. We'll move forward to other discussion items and which I'll just ask the members whether I do have someone that is interested in potentially being a library trustee. So I was wondering, should I just send the records to the mayor, so I said you or
I would just have them fill out that application online. If you want to, and if you also want to shoot her an email, Mayor Moore Wolf, an email or a text, let her know. It's expected.
Is that all we need? Is one more?
No, we're too short.
Too short.
We're
currently at open seats. Yes, we have two of them. So
more. Yeah, because we've got Samantha's seat that didn't get filled, and then May's
signed as well. Actually, I did talk to another individual that is very interested in being on the library board, and she's actually getting her degree in library science currently, but she is not yet a resident of the city of Decatur, so she is working on that and will be doing that with, I believe, with the next 3 to 6 months. So that's another individual. So, yeah, I'm being frank with you.
I know from, I haven't talked in a while, but the last time I talked to the mayor, she difficulty getting all kinds of boards and commissions filled. So.
Oh yeah, my husband's on some fireman's board or something. She begged if you would be on it. So, okay.
Well, seeing the business to be brought forth committee, I will motion to adjourn.
I'll second.
First and second, any discussion? Seeing none.